first.
Hello, Simiatriz. Welcome to our first physics video. This is teacher Nawiso Samuel. We are going to look at electrostatics. This was one of the branches which we looked at when we were still in senior one. Now we are going to look at it in details, electrostatics. We define electrostatics as the study of charges at rest. This is so common when we deal with things which are nanometals. Like for example, when you were still younger, you could get a pen, you rub it in your hair, and then you begin attracting papers or stones. That is what we call the electrostatics. Then when you look at electrostatics, we shall look at this is an electric charge which is ever either deficient or it is in surplus of electrons. And therefore, they can either be positively charged or negatively charged. How does it become positively charged? When it is positively charged, it gives out an electron. But when it is negatively charged, it means that now it just got an electron from somewhere. So now it is negatively charged because it borrowed electrons. It is positively charged because it gave out electrons. Then we shall look at, because our major concern when we're defining physics, we say that this is a study of matter in relation to energy. So we look at matter is made up of atoms. Here we shall look at atoms. Then when you look at atoms, we shall go the idea of chemistry. Then we look at the structure of an atom. What is an atom made of? This table summarizes for us where, how, what is the charge of the particle which is inside. Like for example, we have on the column of particles, we have what we call the proton. The proton is represented by P, which is positively charged, and it is located in the nucleus of an atom. Then we come to what we call the neutron, that is represented by N. This one does not carry any charge, and it is also in the nucleus of an atom. Then we come to what we call the electron, which is E. This one is negatively charged, which is in the outside of the nucleus. Then this one brings us to our diagram, our circular diagram, where we are seeing the nucleus, which is having the neutron and then the proton. Then we come to the next shell or the second shell, which we call the orbit. This orbit is having electrons. So this is the structure of an atom. When they tell you to describe the structure of an atom, you talk about the particles which are inside. They also talk about where are they located. Also talk about the signs of those particles or the charges of those particles. Then you get all your marks. So for that case, after looking at the structure of an atom, in our next video, we shall look at what we call the conductors and then insulators. Have a blessed day.